Here, in the shadow of the San Buenaventura Mission, many ghosts have been reported. We're going to examine those tales, and we have with us EVP, a local Ventura group, looking into the stories of hauntings. They'll come and see if they can confirm some of the many accounts of ghosts at Mission Plaza. Mission Plaza is the home of one of Ventura's Victorian landmarks, the old Carlo Hain House. Right behind me, it's now a popular restaurant where people come from far and wide to hear popular music. But if the stories are true, the old home is also one of the most haunted places in Ventura County. The house was built in 1912, and the story is that an Italian family lived there. They had a daughter who reached the ripe old age of 19 and wasn't married. So the parents quickly found her a husband, an older sea captain, a widow. He was a nice enough fellow. In fact, the lady kind of liked him even. They were married, but he was always away, sometimes as long as 2 years. Well, in that interim, she was living with her parents, and a young Italian fellow came to town, a dashing, handsome man with a mustache. She fell in love with him, and he promised to take her away from little Ventura to the fine city in San Francisco. Well, we don't know if he really planned to do that or what happened, but it seems she became pregnant. Well, she began to wait by the window, looking, trying to see if her boyfriend would come back to take her away, but he never showed up. Finally, in desperation, she went to her bedroom and hung herself. The family heard the chair fall down as she took that final step off and was hanging. They rushed upstairs and cut her down, but she'd broken her neck. Since that day, the house has been haunted by a ghostly woman, sometimes seen wearing a green dress, other times a gray dress, but whatever it is, she haunts the building and has been seen repeatedly since 1970, when it opened as the Big Greenhouse, a family-style restaurant. She's mostly seen in the ladies' bathroom on the second floor. That was her old bedroom and now converted into the bathrooms for the restaurant. People have seen her standing by the mirror or coming down the stairs. She's been seen by many of the wait people. Many of the patrons have had encounters with the ghost they call Rosa. I did find a string of stories connecting this to the early part of the 20th century. So I believe that some tragedy happened here. Whatever it was, it left behind a ghost. Many have tried to find out more about the ghost of Rosa. There are still accounts told and whispered by some of the people who patronize this fine old restaurant. Who she is, we don't really know for sure. Why she still haunts, we can't tell that either. But if you doubt the story is true, go there. Go to the ladies' restroom and see if you don't detect a certain coldness. Maybe you'll have an encounter with Rosa. The old firehouse on Figueroa Street now turned into a fine hotel and restaurant, but it is also rumored to be haunted. And the ghost linked to the old hotel may have nothing to do with the fire department, but may actually go back even farther, because in Mission times, this was the location of the Indian barracks. This is where the married Native Americans were housed. Each one got a small room for their family, a husband and wife. It's believed that one of the Chumash Native Americans affiliated with the Mission died. And in her death, she has remained behind, haunting this particular building. Room 210 is the haunted chamber, and many people who check in say that late at night they see a woman standing in the corner of the room. One lady woke up out of a sound sleep, opened her eyes, and in the dim light coming through the curtain, she saw a woman 6 inches from her nose, staring at her, looking at her face with a confused expression. When she stood up in surprise, thinking someone must have broken in, the woman backed away and then vanished. Many odd things happen in this hotel, and sometimes they blame it upon the ghost. Though 210 is the room the ghost is affiliated with mostly, there are other reports of hauntings in the hallways and in the lobby below. If you don't think it's true, just check into room 210. See what happens to you. The good news, the ghost appears to be friendly and doesn't seem to wish anyone harm. But there was a large Chinese community here. Some 200 members called this place home. They had their own fire department, their own temple, their own stores and businesses. And it seems one of those Chinese has lingered on, has been seen as a ghost time and time again. Who he is and why he's still here, no one knows. We have a ghost hunting team with us from EVP, that's East Ventura Paranormal. They've agreed to come out and see if they can find evidence of some of the many ghosts in Mission Park. Our first site is a place where a Chinese specter has been seen repeatedly. So let's go there and see if we can find out who this Asian phantom happens to be and why they're there, if possible. China Alley. This is where the Chinese community was long ago, before the construction of other buildings. And people in this very site have seen a Chinese gentleman. He's been seen for at least the last 30 years. He's wearing some sort of robe, and he has a small pillbox hat. People, at least four people I know of, have seen and encountered this phantom. Most recently, he's seen just as a ball of light. We're going to let the EVP group come and see if they can find anything out of the ordinary at this location. What are you going to be doing to investigate the site?
Well, we're going to look for things that are unusual. We'll look for electromagnetic fields. We'll look for cold spots. We have cameras. We have infrared cameras. Hopefully, we'll pick something up that way.
Many different Chinese businesses here, laundries. They had their own temple at one time. This was a fully enclosed community where everything they needed was all in one small spot. Most of the Chinese worked as farm laborers here in the area. They were the first migrant farm workers. And unfortunately, they were treated very poorly by the community, who saw them as subhuman in many ways. And they faced unrelenting prejudice.
Was there a strong opium influence?
There was opium. There were several opium dens, but up until 1914, it wasn't even illegal. So, in fact, when they did raid the opium den, which was right across the street, most of the people inside were Yankees, not Chinese.
Is that right?
They also had a Chinese brothel, several different places where the Chinese could enjoy themselves, the gambling dens, things of that nature. They did have a church as well, a Presbyterian.
So they were entrepreneurs just like everybody else.
Very true. Chinese have always been entrepreneurs. They still are. Correct. And they were well represented. Remarkably, 1927, the city forced them all to move. They said that they were bringing plague or they were unclean. So you know what they did? Moved to Oxnard. They just took all their stuff and went over there and reestablished themselves. They even had their own Chinese fire department. And that became, they took their equipment with them, that became the nucleus of the Oxnard Fire Department. They actually had the same cart. And it had these Chinese characters painted on the front of it. It was a hand-pulled cart with a hose on it. And they didn't know what the little symbols mean, so they hired someone from China to translate it. And they thought it was poetry or something like that. It isn't. It says, hold here, don't put hand here. It was just safety instructions. Yeah. What happened? Did you manage to pick up something?
There is a young boy. I get the impression of some phrases and words like Yomi Shui, which for some reason I think is Mandarin. I have no idea because I don't speak any of that language.
I wish we had a Mandarin speaker with us.
But Yomi Shui, and I think he's thirsty. And I don't get any ambivalence from him. I don't get any where he's angry or anything. He's just kind of like acquiesced into a situation. He's young. He's probably late teens. Then... I get the name of, was there a laundry thing around here?
Oh, there were five laundries in this area.
What was the name I was saying? No.
Something like that.
Oh. See, I've lost it because it's going through my head so
fast.
Well,
I do know that direct close by was the Wing High Laundry. And, there was Sing Ki's restaurant, Chinese restaurant, right across the street from us.
It has to do with his uncle who brought him over here. Wo-Hing.
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 There was a Hing. I know that.
Yeah, I get the name Wo-Hing. I get a relationship as an uncle.
Wo is the first name.
Yeah,
Hing is
Wo-Hing.
The last name.
Actually, they're reversed.
I mean, this is what I'm getting. And that's who brought him over here.
They usually had a sponsor of some type. Did you get any other readings, of divergent readings?
No, just a lot of, like, miscellaneous energies and stuff.
Well, there's a lot of activity.
Yeah, but he kind of hit me for a loop once I kind of channeled into him and stuff. But he's not angry, not sad, not scared. He's just kind of acquiesced to a situation where he's just kind of watches.
Do you think if we conducted a Buddhist burial service that might help lay the ghost?
It might, but I think he's just kind of like just hanging out, you know. He's not, I don't know, it's not like he's afraid to reincarnate like the Buddhists, you know, believe and stuff like that. He's just kind of acquiesced to a situation because I think he believed that he was the reason for his situation.
He may have somehow caused it.
Right.
That reincarnating might have him reincarnating a lesser form.
Maybe. I don't know. I mean, I'm not a Buddhist, so I don't know, but though I do believe in reincarnation. I think he's just watching and waiting. I don't know if he's waiting for some kind of deliverance or whatever, but I think he really thinks he's part of the cause of what his situation is right now, or what brought his situation about.
Are you picking up anything more?
Very skinny, with a kind of a white pillbox, I guess a pillbox hat is what you would call it. He wears white and he's barefooted. His feet are very dirty. He's got long toes. I don't know. He reminds me of somebody who's just like waiting for their fate. You know, he just kind of stands there with his hands like in supplication.
So he's here for some reason. We still don't know why. Thank you very much. But it looks like we definitely have confirmed the Chinese ghost is really here. The old mission, San Buenaventura, has been here since its founding on March the 31st, 1782. This is really ground zero where Ventura began as a community. It was founded by Father Junipero Serra, but much of the work of building this huge artifact belongs to another padre, Jose Señan. He was the man who designed it. Many believe that it's the padre himself who haunts here, coming back to see if he can somehow help the parish that he founded. Some say the padre is not really a frightening ghost at all, but in fact some kind of a unknown saint he seems dedicated to helping people. The stories abound of people who have seen and encountered this phantom figure right here at the Ventura Mission. Is this area haunted? We do know these steps have been used a lot, and people have seen ghosts here. Let's try our ghost hunting team and see if they can get anything at this location. Oh, we're getting something here. Ask if there's anything here.
Is anything here with us that can move this pendulum?
It's starting to say yes.
Yeah.
Ask, are you a Native American?
Are you a Native American?
Oh, it's going around much faster now.
Yeah. So,
well, that would make sense. The Native Americans built this place.
Do you live here at the Mission? It's like a no.
No, didn't live here.
Are you buried here?
Seems like yes.
Yeah, looks like a yes.
That might account for it. There are many stories linked to ghosts at the Mission Cemetery, which is right next door. Thank you very much, Sarah, for helping us out with the pendulum reading. Let's see if we got any readings from anyone else. Did you feel anything here?
Especially at the door is hatred, a real overwhelming sense of hatred and misconstrued promises. There is a lot of promises that were broken, and that's the feeling that just keeps working over and over again. I mean, there's no like spirit saying, well, this is what happened or something. It's more of like an overwhelming feel of what has been caught in this area.
That seems to confirm what we got with the pendulum as well. The accounts we get from the psychic side of things seem to indicate that there definitely is some emotional traces left here at the steps of the old Mission.